Welcome back to Breakfast Television. I'm Jenna Khan with your local arts update. Winnipeg's French theatre company, Le Cirque Molière, will start its 2014-2015 season with the psychological thriller La Chanson de l'Elephant, or Elephant Song, on now until October 25th.
Vous êtes médecin?
Oui.
Psychiatrist Dr. Lawrence has vanished from his office, and the last person to see him was a troubled patient with an obsession with elephants. The hospital director is determined to interrogate the patient, despite warnings from the head nurse. And actor Yvan Lecuyer says he expects audience members will spend the evening on the edge of their seats.
I think they're going to enjoy feeling that tension in their seat. They're going to feel at the edge, and they're going to feel involved, and they're just going to have that adrenaline within them as well. So I think they're going to enjoy that rush.
Wonder what Josh did.
Sarasvati Productions takes a powerful theatrical journey on the road and into Manitoba schools, exploring the issue of youth in the care of CFS. The story follows two young people as they move through the system and allows the audience to take part, stopping the action of the play to step in and try out positive solutions to the problems addressed in the play. From the stigma of being in care to the challenges of an overloaded system, Giving Voice explores real issues that children in care deal with on a daily basis.
The difficulty for them is their peers understanding what they're going through and why sometimes they're called to the office because their social worker's there, or why sometimes they might act out because there's so much that they're dealing with. So it was really the youth that identified to us, this is our goal and we want it to be targeted to other youth.
The 27th annual Winnipeg Irish Festival takes place this weekend with a kickoff party here at Shannon's Irish Pub tonight, featuring workshops throughout the weekend and their big gala concert event happening tomorrow night out at the West End Cultural Centre with Echoes of Erin all the way from Ireland.
The M and the H are silent, which
Ray Harris is the president of Cultus Winnipeg, which was organized to promote and preserve traditional Irish music.
It's important to the people with Irish background, but it's also important that Canadians know that we're a multicultural society and this is the real thing, this is the real culture, not the kind of commercial culture you sometimes see.
Visit breakfasttelevision.ca to win a pair of weekend passes to this year's Irish Fest. Follow the links to contests for your chance to win and enter under the daily prizing tab.
Make it real easy, make it all right.
In late 2010, Winnipeg blues singer Romi Mayes teamed up with lifelong friend Jay Nowicki of the Perpetrators to write and perform a live original electronic duo album. And a new documentary screening this weekend has captured the great singing and picking as well as a live set at the West End Cultural Centre. After the Show is a tribute to independent musicians and their commitment to their craft, despite a lack of widespread financial fame. For Breakfast Television, I'm Jenna Khan.